Today is Monday, the 14th of November, and it is super moon, and I'm going to photograph it tonight. But for starters, I need to go to the Hazelmere Dam. I confirmed on Friday with Mgeni Water that something is happening at the dam that has not been published in the newspaper yet. And I'm not going to tell you now up front. I want you to come with me and to have a look. But it's definitely going to be a pleasant surprise, and I would love it if you can go with me. I will show a lot of things that's happening there. If you haven't seen it yet, and you've always been interested, you can actually have a look. There's some other videos of me that you can see as well. It'll show how the drought affected the river and the dam over quite a period. But today, we are at a new phase in the new dam's history. I call it the new dam because that's exactly what it is and will be. Let's go. Today is the 14th of November 2016. This is how the dam wall progressed. The dam stands at 71% this morning, and you will see on my footage that they are letting out a lot of water, obviously not to affect the building works. They can't really allow the water to go any higher, so the dam will be stabilized at this level. It looks quite good. It's very promising because the dam's capacity will be increased by this raising of the dam wall. So by June 2017, we should have this ready and completed. And that will do a lot if we get the necessary rainfall to back up the dam. It's wonderful. Perfect, man. I haven't seen a dam as full as this for a long time. This is the first time actually I saw this dam like this. 71% today. They've let out a lot of water to keep the dam at this level because they can't afford it to go much higher because they're busy with the construction work on the dam wall. I am very impressed. I'm very impressed, and it's beautiful to see this because this dam has been empty for a long time and we were in a dire situation. You can almost imagine that they don't really care how much water we use at this moment because there's abundance of water. But the situation can always change quite fast, so we can never sit on our laurels as far as this is concerned. Guys, man, this is special. I don't know what to say to you, man. This is good stuff. Thank you. Yes, it's filling up.
Looks better than it used to.
Yeah, it can't fill up more because they're working there. They're letting water out there.
You're running a survey?
No, I'm taking a video.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hey, hope we don't get recorded.
You are, but it doesn't matter.
Sorry, I didn't know.
Wow, things are looking much different now from the last visit. Let's go and have a look down there, man. You know, last time I've been here, the river was flowing very strong. It was actually calving into the embankment. Today the river is flowing, but it is a white, slow river because the dam has pushed it back so much that it's actually part of the dam now. And it's a complete different situation from the past. The river is obviously also quite deep because you can see how high up it is. It's completely different. Things have changed so much and it is such a good thing, and there's probably more rain on the way, but as I said, they can't let more water get into the dam, they have to let it out. So it will be interesting to know if they can cope on that side, if their sluice gates can actually handle a big flood at the moment, because normally your dam will overflow when you have lots of rain. It's quite gloomy, but normal rainfall was predicted for this period. We don't know if anything will get out of hand, but it's lovely. I'm just happy to see this. You're not going to believe this. This dam is full here, and where I used to have to walk through the mud to get to the water, the motorboat launch are covered now, so they can actually launch the motorboats. And that's what the lady at the gate also told me. All the ablution blocks here are going to be moved eventually because of the doubling of the wall. So the piece of land here will be much smaller, the picnic spot will be much smaller. So it's going to be quite a nice leisure dam once it's completed. It's nice to see this. I'm quite impressed by this. Look, it's all the way down. All the way. I'm so impressed with this. I'm so impressed. So as I said, this is where I used to go. Walk through the mud. A lot of people done that. A lot of journalists. We had lots of interesting photos. Nobody can do that anymore for the immediate future. It's in the past. It's so beautiful here, it's so green. The green is actually luscious green, you know, like a nitrogen green, very fertile. And it's actually a very beautiful day here today. Nature is special. It's actually a nice place to come down to for a visit. I can recommend this. So there in the background is the water tower which I visited before to take photos from the top. July 2015, that was around about that time, when it was very dry here, and I wanted to show how the water was coming in from the pipeline. Now the pipeline is not even working at the moment because there's no need in pumping water into the dam, because they're actually trying to reduce the water. So actually, when I drove past there, I realized that obviously it's not going to work. I just wanted to confirm it, definitely not working. No point in wasting all that energy to pump the water. I will be going back soon, but I just hope you enjoy this video. I hope this video was informative. You know, it's obviously not everybody can come down there, but everybody's interested to know what's going on. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, because I want to make more of these things. And it actually is quite an effort to do this, you know, lots of editing, lots of stuff to do. And I want to carry on with this. So like it, subscribe to my channel, and watch more of my videos. And make suggestions, you know. I like interaction. It will be lovely. Thanks very much.